Hi, I'm Corey. I'm a CPA and subject matter expert in managerial accounting. And in this video, we're going to discuss the concept of process value analysis. We'll start off with a brief discussion on what process value analysis is. Next, we'll break down the key components of this model and develop an understanding of how companies can use this model to make better business decisions. Understanding this approach allows companies to improve both customer value and profitability. So let's get started. Have you ever looked at a routine activity that you undertake each day and thought about whether it could be done differently? Maybe you find yourself running out the door each morning late for work. To change this, you might want to sit down and think about why this is happening and start to consider whether there's certain activities you can eliminate or do more efficiently in order to save yourself time each morning. Companies use activity-based management to help them address similar issues in their business. Activity-based management is a way to evaluate the various activities within a business, narrowing in on each area to determine its strengths and weaknesses. This allows organizations to determine which areas of the business they need to look at in order to improve. Process value analysis is a part of activity-based management that companies use to examine their internal processes in an effort to streamline them so that they can reduce costs and provide more value to their customers. The goal of process value analysis is to look at individual processes and break them down to ensure that they're operating as efficiently as possible. This is done by employing the process value analysis model with the following three steps. Driver analysis asks why the company is doing what they're doing. The activities step looks at what actions they're currently taking. And in the performance analysis phase, we look at how well the company is performing this process. Ultimately, this will help the organization remove any unnecessary steps and expenses without sacrificing the satisfaction of the customer. In the driver analysis phase, the goal is to identify the root cause of each activity that's performed in order to understand all of the activity inputs and outputs. Understanding the root cause can help companies manage their costs more effectively. Activity inputs are the resources that are used up by the activity and feed directly into producing an output. Activity output is the frequency of the activity leading to the result the company is looking to achieve by undertaking that activity. For example, if the activity is packing and sorting orders at a warehouse, the inputs could be the forklift, the maintenance, and fuel for the forklift, the employees such as the forklift driver, and the laborers that sort and pack the order for shipping. The output here would be the number of orders packed. The goal here would be to pinpoint the factors that are the root causes of the activity costs. In our example, the root cause of the order packing costs might be attributed to the inefficient layout of the warehouse. The next phase would be the activity analysis step, where the organization identifies and evaluates all activities within the process to determine which ones are value-added activities and which ones are non-value-added activities. Value-added activities are the ones that are absolutely necessary to be able to get the job done. There's three criteria to be considered value-adding. The process generates a financial impact. The financial impact was not attainable through previous processes. And the process enables future financial planning to be executed. In our example from earlier, the step where a forklift is required to pull the inventory down and transport it to packing area meets these three criteria and would therefore be considered value-adding. Non-value-added activities are all other types of activities, other than the ones that are absolutely required to stay in business and complete the task. For example, if someone was required to inspect each package before it was shipped to the customer in order to ensure the right products had been pulled, this would be considered a non-value-added activity. Instead of spending time providing value to the customer, in this case the company would be spending time on additional steps such as inspection or quality control after the fact, when they could have just had a strong enough process in place at the start to ensure things were done correctly. While this process might help the company improve quality, if things were done correctly in the first place, it wouldn't be necessary because it requires additional time, resources, and costs. The goal of this whole phase of the process would be to identify those non-value-added activities and determine whether it would be possible to eliminate them from the overall process. Now that we understand the first two phases of process value analysis, let's talk about a common misconception. Just because an activity has been deemed non-value-added doesn't necessarily mean it has to be eliminated from the process. Ultimately, the goal is to remove as many non-value-added activities as possible, but there's times where this is not always feasible. Companies want to make sure that they do not disrupt the overall process too fast and need to make sure the necessary changes have been made first. There could be serious consequences in the event the company eliminates steps that they thought were non-value-added. If they eliminate the wrong activities or remove the right ones too quickly, the consequences could result in delayed delivery of goods and services, which could negatively impact their relationships with customers. Now that we've looked at the driver analysis and activity analysis phases, let's look at the last phase, which is performance analysis. This is the step where companies assess how well their processes are performed, focusing on the following three dimensions: efficiency, time, and quality. Efficiency looks at how well the activity inputs are being used to produce the activity outputs. In order to improve efficiency, the company can look for ways to produce the same final output with reduced costs to the inputs. In our package packing example from earlier, the company could measure the average cost per package packed and look for ways to bring this cost down over time without impacting the quality. The next dimension of performance analysis is time, which is an important measure for companies to consider. The longer it takes them to complete the process, the more resources it's consuming, usually resulting in additional cost. In our example from earlier, where the company was required to sort and pack packages, the company could measure the average time that it takes to sort and pack each package and look for ways to improve this metric. The final dimension is quality. Ultimately, the company wants to ensure that it's producing a high-quality product the first time the activity is performed, to avoid additional time and resources. This can be measured on how much the company is spending on quality-related activities, such as inspection, rework, and scrap costs. Quality costs can be a significant expense for companies, and if managed well, can result in substantial improvements in overall profitability. Spending time assessing all three of these dimensions can provide crucial insights into how well the company is performing their processes. And that brings us to the end of this video. Remember, in order for organizations to be successful in the long run, they need efficient and effective processes. The process value analysis model discussed in this video is an extremely useful approach that can result in significant improvements to the business. If you're interested in learning more about this topic or others, please feel free to check out our additional videos on many more related topics.